Sally Granz Korsch. I'm the Director of Facilities Management, Environmental Policy, and NACUBO, which is the National Association of College and University Business Officers. There are about 4,500 colleges and universities in the United States. About 2,200 members belong to us. And we're serving to train, advocate, and do research on behalf of colleges and universities, the business offices. And we're here today because it's really important that colleges and universities have stepped up to the plate and are doing renewables, are doing energy efficiency, and are both training students as well as being mentors and models in the community. All of these examples here, and I hope you get a chance to pan them, are fantastic examples of how renewable is working. Behind me is George Mason University, which is actually, it's grown by 46%, but at the same time it's only increased its energy 20%. Bowdoin College actually has more, it's 7 times larger in solar collectors than any other place in the state of Maine. That's amazing for a small little college to make that kind of endeavor. Up here I need to point out the University of Wisconsin in Oshkosh, a public university, has used funds to both do biodigesters, both wet and dry, geothermal, solar, and wind, and they are literally going to be off the grid soon on their consumption. I love talking about Arizona State University and that there's 78,000 solar panels and 76,000 students. These guys have more solar panels than students. Could talk on and on about what's done at Berkeley, Westchester University, University of California, Irvine, and UCLA. All of them are doing amazing stuff in water savings and energy efficiency and renewables. A lot of campuses are starting to do combined heat and power, which also serve not only their own campus, but also the community at large. It's amazing what colleges and universities are doing, and here's the problem. A lot of people don't realize that, and a lot of people don't connect the dots. And through benign neglect, sometimes legislative actions don't include us, and that's a really important piece, that they should be including us in their endeavors. So, we need help. A lot of us have done the low-hanging fruit, and what we need to do is we need to get the higher, deeper energy retrofits and renewables, because we can be a service to the community at large.